Hello student and welcome you again to the class 1. We are learning subject maths. Yes, and in previous video we have started our chapter 4. So in this video also we will continue this chapter. So in this video we are going to see subtraction on the number strip. How to subtract using number strip. Okay, for that student you have to open your textbook page number 46. What can you see? The heading is there on the top, subtraction on the number strip. Yes, like addition we can also subtract the on the number strip. Yes, we can use number strip for subtraction also. So let us start. Okay, see what subtraction is given to you. 7 minus 3. 7 minus 3. Now you have to subtract the number 3 from the 7. So what you have to do, you have to start counting from the 7 and take 3 steps backward, okay, or jump 3 steps backward. In addition we jump forward, but in subtraction you have to jump backward. So put your pencil on number 7. Very good. Now you have to jump 3 steps backward. So jump 3 steps backward. 1 2 and 3. So where you reach, student? Yes, you reach to the number 4, or you reach at number 4. So you have to write the number 4 in answer place, because your answer is 4. When you subtract 3 from 7 using number strip, what you did, you jump 3 steps backward and you reach to the number 4. So you can say that 7 minus 3 equal to 4. Okay, now we will see another example also. Now here I gave one extra example, 5 minus 2. Okay, so how will you do? Yes, you have to put a pencil on number 5 and take or jump 2 steps backward. Okay, so put your pencil on number 5 and jump 2 steps backward. 1 and 2. Where you reach? You reach to the number 3. So our answer is 3. So write down the 3 in the box. Yes. And how will you read it? 5 minus 2 equal to 3. Okay. Now, student, below that you can see one exercise also. Yes. In a yellow box there is an exercise given. Subtract the following numbers using the number strip. You have to solve these examples in your textbook itself. Okay. So see what example is given first. 8 minus 3. Okay. 8 minus 3. When you want to subtract 3 from the 8, what you have to do? You have to put a pencil on number 8 and jump 3 steps backward. Start. 1, 2, 3. Yes, what is your answer? You reach to the number 5, so 5 is your answer. Write down 5 in the box. Yes, 8 minus 3 equal to 5 is equal to 5. Now see the next example, 9 minus 2. Okay, so now what you have to do? You have to put pencil on number 9 and take or jump 2 steps backward. Ready? Start. 1 and 2. Your answer is 7. Yes, you reach to the number, you reach at number 7. So you can say that 9 minus 2 equal to 7. Now student, see the third example. 6 minus 5. So what you have to do again? You have to put a pencil on number 6 and jump 5 steps backward. So put a pencil on number 6 and start jumping backward. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. You reach at number 1. So 1 is your answer. Write down the answer in the box. Yes. 6 minus 5 is equal to 1. Now there are more examples. Yes, two more examples. 5 minus 1 and 7 minus 5. That are your PH. Yes, now you learn how to subtract on the number stream. So you have to solve these examples by yourself as a PH. Okay, now we will move to our next topic, that is vertical subtraction. Yes, like addition, you can also subtract vertically. Okay, you can also subtract numbers by representing the vertically. Okay, now see, one example is given here, 5 minus 2. Here what you have to do, you have to draw lines and cross it. Yes, so we will see this pattern first, okay, or method first. Now number 5 and 2 are given. So 5 is a upper number or bigger number and 2 is a smaller number given here. Student, you have to always remember that you can subtract a smaller number from the bigger number, only smaller number from the bigger number. So the number 5 is given upper side, so there are 5 lines drawn. How many lines are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we are going to subtract 2 from the 5. So we have to cross 2 lines. How many lines you will cut here? 2. So cut 2 lines. 1 and 2. Now how many lines remain here? 1, 2, 3. 3 lines remain here. So your answer is 3. So write down 3 in the box. Yes. Now you can read it like 5 minus 2 equal to 3. Okay. Student, now you have to open textbook page number 47. There is mind it given. Yes. So always subtract a smaller number from a bigger number. This trick I always already told you, you can subtract only smaller number from the bigger number. Yes. Now some examples are given. Subtract the following. Yes. Now in the textbook it is given, subtract the following by drawing lines and crossing out the lines. But we are going to see the another method. So here is only given, subtract the following. Okay. Now see the first example, 7 minus 2. So what you have to do, see, 7 is a upper number and 2 is a lower number. So what you have to do, you have to start from the lower number or smaller number, from the smaller number to the bigger number. Yes, means you have to start counting forward from 2 up to 7. Okay, so let us start. Count after 2 on your fingers. Okay, see, I am showing my finger. After 2, you have to count. After 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now see how many fingers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So your answer is 5. So write down number 5 here. Yes, what we did? We start counting from 2 and we reach to the number 7. And count how many fingers are there. Okay. Now let us see one more example here, 6 minus 3. Okay, now 6 is a upper number and 3 is a lower number. So what will you do? You will start counting from the lower number to the upper number. Means you will start from the counting from the 3 up to 6. Okay, count on your fingers. How will you count? Count on your fingers. So after 3, you have to start counting till 6. After 3, 4, 5 and 6. How many fingers are here now? 1, 2 and 3. So your answer is 3. So write down the 3 in the box. Yes. 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. Now students, see the next example, 3 minus 2. Now we are going to use the same method. Start counting from lower number and reach to the upper number. So here lower number is 2 and upper number is 3. So we will start counting from 2 and reach to the 3. Okay. After 2, it's 3. Only one finger is there. So your answer is 1. So write down the answer 1. Yes. So student, you understand how to subtract using this method? Yes. Start counting from the lower number till upper number. Count the fingers and write answer. Okay. Now 3 more examples are here. That is your pH. Okay, that are your pH. 8 minus 2, 8 minus 6 and 9 minus 5. Yes, can you solve it by yourself? Yes, I am sure you can. Yes. Now student, below that there is a smart tip given. What is the smart tip? Just read it. Subtraction can be done in both ways. Okay, see. First, it is given horizontally as 9 minus 2 equal to 7 as well as 9 minus 2 equal to 7 vertically also. The answer remains same in both the cases. Yes, if you wrote it vertically or horizontally also, the answer remains same. Understand? Now, we will move to our next concept, that is subtracting 0, that is subtracting 0. So put your finger there. When we subtract 0 from a number, the answer is the number itself. Okay. When we subtract 0 from any number, the answer will be number itself. Now see, there are 8 candies. Can you see 8 candies in the first box? Yes. And none of them have been eaten. None of them have been eaten means no candies. Yes, no candies are eaten by anybody. So, means 0. So, 8 minus 0 equal to, when there are 8 candies and none of them have been eaten, means all are as it is. Yes. So, your answer is how many candies left now? Yes. So, 8 candies are left. Because when we subtract 0 from any number, the answer is number itself. Understand? Now, suppose your father or mother gives you 4 chocolates and you not eaten any one. Okay. So, how many chocolates remain? Yes, 4. So, means the number itself. Now, we will see some examples. Mind it, student. One thing is given. Yes, mind it. For that, you have to open page number 48. Yes. When we subtract 0 from any number, the answer is not a 0. Yes, it is wrong. Answer is number itself. See, 5 minus 0 equal to 0. It is a wrong answer. And 5 minus 0 equal to 5 is a correct answer. So, see the exercise given below. Okay. What is given? Fill in the boxes. One has been done for you. Now you have to fill in the boxes, subtract the numbers and write the correct answer. One has been done for you. 4 minus 0 equal to 4. How answer is 4 is given there? Because when we subtract 0 from any number, the answer is number itself. So 4 minus 0 equal to 4. So same like 3 minus 0 equal to, yes, 3, number itself. 5 minus 0 equal to 5, number itself. So student, remaining are your pH. Yes, remaining examples are your pH. It is so much easy, you can solve it very properly. Okay student, in next video, we will see the next concept. Subtracting the same number and word problem. Till then, student, thank you very much. Have a nice day. Bye.